Hello everyone, my name is Sylvain Lafrance and it is my great pleasure to welcome you to the annual public meeting in my new role as chair of the board of Telefilm Canada. It is a true honor to be here. For the benefit of those who cannot see me, I will describe myself. I'm a middle-aged man with short curly hair sitting in a movie theater in Montreal. I also have a big smile on my face to show how happy I am to be back in the Canadian audiovisual sector through Telefilm. I want to take this moment to acknowledge that Telefilm's headquarters here in Montreal are on unceded Indigenous lands, historically known as a gathering place for many First Nation peoples. I'd also like to recognize all the Indigenous creators who are contributing more and more to the success of our cinema, telling their stories and their ambitions and enriching our Canadian and international audiovisual landscape. I begin my terms as chair of the board with a great sense of purpose. Our industry faces challenges. To address them, Telefilm's leadership is implementing a comprehensive three-year strategic plan that aims for a global approach to support the audiovisual industry through direct investment in our cinema. As I take up this position, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to my predecessor, Robert Spickler, for his work over his five-year term at Telefilm, overseeing the challenging pandemic years and its recovery. I'm delighted to be working alongside Julie Roy, Executive Director and CEO of Telefilm. Her passionate leadership and her first year in this role has been inspirational. I'm delighted to be teaming up with her. Telefilm has an essential mission for the Canadian audiovisual industry, especially now, as we are in a time that demands our full attention. There are challenges. Disruption. Our landscape is evolving, and at the same time, the role that our organization plays has never been more important. At Telefilm, we believe in the power of cinema as a crucial economic and cultural force. Cinema creates opportunities for discussions, exchange of ideas. It is part of the fabric of a healthy society, especially at a time when polarizing forces can pull us apart. As the largest investor in Canadian and Indigenous cinema, Telefilm is dedicated to supporting thousands of creators across this country, collaborating with partners at every point in the life cycle of a film, developing unique, diverse voices that reflect our identity, fueling our dynamic culture economy, and driving demand for Canadian screen content. Now I'd like to talk about the importance of a new strategic vision. As part of that vision, this last fiscal year was a time of strategic redirection. Julie and the management committee consulted at length with industry stakeholders to develop a detailed plan that will have a lasting impact. The new strategic direction is supported by a transparent and robust governance structure. Should we speak more about the changes within the organization? But why these changes? It's simple. To modernize, to adapt to changes, to focus on partnerships, and to position Telefilm as a unifying force in the industry. We're all aware of the issues facing our sector in the last year, the slowdown of economic growth, high interest rates, persistent inflation that is only now easing, rising unemployment, and strikes in the American film industry that had an impact on our sector. But the highlights of the year also reveal some good news, uplifting news. A welcome momentum is underway. The Canadian government clearly recognizes the crucial importance of the audiovisual sector as creator of jobs, revenue, pride, cultural identity, and more than that, to share an inclusive humanity. I want to thank the Government of Canada and Canadian Heritage for the additional $50 million per year for the next 2 years. It's a great vote of confidence, a vote of trust that cannot be overstated. As we look ahead, this additional $50 million must become a permanent contribution to ensure predictability and stability in our industry. When I say there's momentum, I think we can all feel it. And of course, we see it in the numbers. Last year, revenue from total box office sales was up 33%, and Canadian film had a stellar year of theatrical releases, Telefilm playing a significant role in that success. Because the public sector is a force behind the scenes. When you're sitting in a theater, enjoying a film, learning and laughing, and at times moved to tears, it is often with the help of Telefilm that it is brought to the screen. Last year, 7 Telefilm-supported films enjoyed box office success exceeding $1 million. Here are just a few. Louise Archambault, Le Temps d'un été, was number one in ticket sales. The success of Matt Johnson's Blackberry and the success of Charles-Olivier Michaud's Rue. Congratulations to all our creators for your excellent work. We're deeply proud to be your partners. In closing, I would like to reinforce my support for Julie Roy and her management team for the thoughtful shift of our organization. This will position us for even greater success. Thanks to all Telefilm employees who bring their expertise and passion to their work. It is all a team effort. I would also like to take this time to thank my colleagues on the board for their enthusiasm and for welcoming me as chair. In turn, I welcome 2 new board members, Claude Doucet and Deborah McPherson. We look forward to continue to work together. And I want to thank outgoing board members Angèle Beausoleil and Karen Archer for their years of service. At the end of the day, our work is all about common good. It's about the Canadians and Indigenous peoples whose story move and engage audiences around the world. Stories that illuminate subjects close to our heart and showcase our identity as a country made up of many perspectives and realities. I have an immense respect for this mission and for the crucial role of public service in our cultural landscape. And so I strongly believe in Telefilm's important commitment to partnerships and supporting our creators. Now, I would like to introduce Julie Roy, Executive Director and CEO of Telefilm Canada, to speak. Thank you.
Thank you, Sylvain, and welcome everyone to Telefilm Canada's annual public meeting. I will start by describing myself for those who cannot see me. I'm a middle-aged woman with curly blonde hair and blue eyes, wearing a blue dress, and I'm sitting in a movie theater. It's a pleasure to speak to you today. I welcome your questions in the comments section, as my team is currently available to answer them live. I also invite you to read our recent 2023-24 annual report, available on our website for detailed information on what I'll be talking about. I'm speaking to you today to review the past fiscal year. It's been my first year as Executive Director and CEO of Telefilm Canada, an intense year and an important time. At a time when our industry is mobilizing to meet major challenges, we are at a transformative moment. And it is against this backdrop that my management team and I have made it a strategic priority to re-evaluate Telefilm's program. Why did we do this? Because we listened to your concerns and needs, along with our partners, sister agencies, associations, our collaborators. And how are we going to achieve this? By working with our partners, participating in important discussions, and exchanging ideas. The mission of Telefilm hasn't changed. Our goal is always to provide impactful and sustainable support for the economic prosperity and cultural importance of Canadian and Indigenous cinema and make it shine. But it is how we get there that is going to change. And so we have developed a 3-year strategic plan, an ambitious plan that will enable us to adapt to the profound changes taking place in the audiovisual industry. We have a responsibility to ensure that our investment reaches every point of contact in the value chain. We are going to continue to meet the new realities of our industry, including AI. We will maintain Telefilm's role as an impactful partner of choice. And I can tell you this, in all those conversations I had, one thing is clear. Our industry is made up of passionate creators and we all rally behind what we like to call the unifying power of cinema, our cinema, the diverse voices across this country, voices that, despite their sometimes different realities, are united by this conviction. And I share it too. I have my whole career. It's been 30 years since. This commitment to our cinema is truly at the core of all the relationships Telefilm has with partners and audiences at home and on the international scene. So what is the vision and what did we achieve in fiscal 2023-24? First of all, to streamline our activities and align more closely with our strategic vision, we began by implementing internal reorganizations by regrouping certain sectors. For example, finance and IT are under one vice president. We also brought our government relations and communications under one team. One major change is that our core activities have been brought into a single portfolio of program strategy and industry development to maximize efficiency and impact. And finally, ESG and sustainability practices have been expanded and integrated across the organization. This brings me to my next point of discussion, our programs, which is at the heart of how we achieve our mission. When we began examining our programs, we looked closely at the ecosystem of the audiovisual sector. It is complex and interconnected. We know that a production's life cycle has many stages with specific needs and challenges. To us, that means many opportunities for support. We call this the continuum of the film industry. In fact, it's the entire value chain, from pre-development to development, from production to post-production, from national distribution to international. And it is here, at these contact points, that Telefilm provides funding programs. Our approach is holistic, considering all the aspects of our industry where our partners play a crucial role in ensuring that our stories and our creators shine. And we stand on the threshold of a new fiscal year. We launch our 2024-27 strategic plan, together for a lasting impact. I'd like to take a moment now to recap some of the highlights from last year. To begin, I want to point out that the year 2023-24 was the third and final year of integration of additional funding from the 2021 federal budget. And our funding was put to very effective use. In all, Telefilm's programs and activities funneled nearly $139 million into the creative economy. Over $84 million was invested in 141 feature film projects in production. And this year was a special one for documentaries. Over $7 million went into theatrical documentaries. This is the highest level of support in Telefilm's theatrical documentary program in 10 years. In part, this is because over $2 million was reallocated to bolster documentaries at a time when strikes by the American unions and guilds paralyzed many productions. Not only that, but new guidelines also allowed for greater financial participation per documentary. Truly Canadian documentaries continue to stand out. Earlier this year, we were delighted to celebrate the success of Nisha Pahuja's To Kill a Tiger, which earned a prestigious Oscar nomination for Best Documentary. In our development program, we invested close to $12 million in over 300 projects. In the area of promotional support, over $32 million went into over 100 Canadian film festivals. On top of that, over 110 international festival and industry activities received funding. Meanwhile, our marketing and audience engagement initiatives received over $6 million more than the prior year, which led to the support of 95 Canadian feature films. This is because more films had theatrical releases in 2023-24, an increase since the pandemic years. We also observed that our 2023-24 marketing campaigns were more robust in scale than in the previous year. It is significant to note that Telefilm financed close to $5 million to help market 10 big-budget feature films last year. As you can see, we have truly made significant investments. So what exactly do these investments mean? It means the creation of jobs. In 2022-23, Canadian screen-based content production generated nearly 240,000 jobs. Jobs are created at every point of that continuum I have spoken about. This is why our structure of investing at each critical stage of a project's journey has an impact, an economic impact, as well as an impact on our culture and outreach. To name just a few examples, Monia Chokri's Simple Comme Sylvain won Best Foreign Film at the César Awards in France. Cody Lightning's Hey Victor was nominated for 3 Canadian Screen Awards. And Zahar Khan's In Flames made its world debut in Cannes. Of course, there are many other examples. I extend my warmest congratulations to all the teams. As we look forward, I can assure you that Telefilm is at the forefront of conversations about the modernization of Canada's audiovisual industry. We're engaged with the CRTC about the implementation of the new framework that will ensure contributions to Canadian and Indigenous content. As Sylvain Lafrance noted, at the end of last fiscal, it was announced that Telefilm would receive an additional $50 million per year for the next 2 years. I want to thank Canadian Heritage for seeing the value of our work. But I want to emphasize, it is crucial to make this extra funding permanent. Predictability is key to the long-term future of our industry. Against this backdrop of instability, I also want to tell you that all of us in the audiovisual sector are collaborating, sharing insights and information that will benefit everyone. The National Film Board, the Business Development Bank of Canada, the Indigenous Screen Office, and of course, the Canada Media Fund. This is a time to come together because collaboration is our greatest asset. And co-productions are a great example of collaboration. We know the importance of co-productions. The financial participation of foreign countries boosts the budgets and audience reach for Canadian producers. In 2023-24, Telefilm recommended 57 films and TV co-productions involving 22 partner countries to Canadian Heritage. To support Canadian producers' access to funding, we maintain strong relations with key international partners, such as URIMAGE, the New Dam Fund, and the Arctic Indigenous Film Fund. What is particularly close to our hearts is Indigenous cinema. Indigenous cinema is an integral part of Telefilm's vision. Our allyship with Indigenous communities is a priority, listening and learning as we move towards reconciliation. This year, with the help of an Indigenous advisory committee led by my colleagues at Telefilm, we developed and launched an Indigenous reconciliation plan. This is a living and ever-evolving document. I want to thank my Telefilm colleagues and the committee. Your ideas, your insights, perspectives, and advice have been of great value in developing this plan. We have learned a lot, and we've been inspired by Indigenous practices as we evolved our own at Telefilm. I'd now like to take a moment to highlight a few of our corporate accomplishments with regard to internal plans. We completed phase one of the Sustainability Action Plan. Key funding targets were met for historically underrepresented groups. We published the first edition of program results from our self-identification data collection, and our inaugural Accessibility Plan Progress Report was released. These plans demonstrate our commitment to diversity, accessibility, and sustainability. And I think they show that we are taking concrete, responsible, and measurable actions that go far beyond words. In fact, these principles are fundamental to our work and are applied by every member of our organization. And they have earned us some awards to be proud of. For a second straight year, Telefilm was named one of Montreal's top employers by MediaCorp Canada. And we also earned the Silver Parity Certificate by Women in Governance. Our team of over 200 employees is valuable to us, and we deeply appreciate each one of them. We know that with a happy, engaged, and equitable team, we all succeed. This fall, Telefilm announced the reopening of an office space in Halifax. It's important to maintain this presence and to have employees on site to support the booming film industry in Atlantic Canada. We have teams of experts across Canada. To conclude, I'd like to return to the topic of cinema. The success of Canadian and Indigenous cinema is rooted in teamwork, collaborations, partnerships, discussions, sometimes difficult but necessary, and mutual understanding of issues and viewpoints. Telefilm is deeply interconnected to this intricate industry ecosystem and uniquely equipped to ensure that is mobilized and modernized for the future. The development of our three-year strategic plan is a result from concerted efforts and discussions with many of you. And I want to thank you for your participation, contribution, and commitment. Despite the challenges ahead, we're excited. We want to continue working together for the continued success and brilliance of Canadian and Indigenous cinema. Finally, on a more personal note, I'd like to say that my first year of leading Telefilm has been incredibly stimulating. I feel truly privileged to contribute to an industry that I hold so dear to my heart. We'll now go into our Q&A session. We will answer questions we've received via email from the industry. Thank you for taking the time to send your questions in advance. If you have questions now, you are welcome to submit them in our comment section. We have a team who can help answer them live. So let's get started. How is Telefilm addressing AI in the industry? When we address the new realities of our industry, AI is definitely part of the conversation. In our 24-27 strategic plan, AI is incorporated in our three-year strategy. We intend to adopt a holistic and responsible approach to implementing AI. We know AI will impact all areas of our industry, so this is definitely a corporate priority for us. How many people working in executive positions at Telefilm have experience in the film industry, particularly as producers and/or directors? That's a great question. I'm very honored to be in the film business for over 30 years. In that time, I produced over 50 animated projects, where some received international recognition at Cannes, Berlin, and Annecy. I've also had the privilege of overseeing production studios nationwide during my time at the NFB, which include overseeing distribution and marketing. As for our colleagues and staff, at every level, we have experts who have direct experience in production, directing, as well as marketing and distribution. Beyond that, we also have an array of experts who specialize in their roles that are equipped to support the audiovisual industry. We welcome you to visit our About Us webpage at telefilm.ca, where you will find profiles of our management committee and their relevant experiences. A number of large productions refuse to sign collective agreements with organizations representing film and TV workers, which leaves workers unprotected. In the absence of requiring that production companies remain in good standing with unions and guilds, what is Telefilm's plan to hold production companies accountable? Well, thank you for this question. I want to start by acknowledging that fair working conditions are important. As an investor in Canada's creative industries, Telefilm is committed to supporting a healthy ecosystem that thrives in a culture of integrity, dignity, and mutual respect. Telefilm is in discussions with unions and guilds on these matters, and we are exploring how we can contribute to finding sustainable solutions in this space. What is Telefilm doing about oversubscription in its funding programs? We understand that oversubscription is across the board for public institutions. There has been an increased volume of applications year over year. This represents the growing pool of talent of our country in every value chain, from development to production to marketing and distribution. With the increasing volume of applicants, the readiness of a project is a major factor in our advisory committee's evaluation process. As I've mentioned earlier, Telefing is undergoing a strategic review for all our funding programs as part of our strategic plan. We have already started this process. Our program strategy and industry development team, led by Francesca Accinelli, is working hard with industry members to reassess and revamp our programs over the next 3 years. So we're done with our Q&A session. Thank you so much for everyone's questions. We'll make sure we answer all the questions that we've received through email and in the comments section. And once again, thank you for joining us today and have a great day.